Hello, so guys, today I'm going to show you how you can fix this problem over here. CE-108262-9. And this problem is a problem occurred in the system software the last time your PS5 was used. So what I get this problem, I get this like a couple times in a week, guys. And this is quite annoying. And this is now just a screenshot that I took once I got this problem. So I'm gonna show some couple things what you can try out to fix this problem. And first off, guys, if you have a disk version like this one, I have a disk version of the PS5, it always gives me this problem. It's quite annoying. So what you wanna first off do is, before starting off your PS5, pull out your disk, and then you wanna start off your PS5, or it's already started. I don't know if you pulled the disk out that it's already starts off your PS5, but you want to do that exactly. And what you want to do is, if it nothing, like nothing shows off on the screen, you just want to go ahead and close it back off and close it back on and see if it works out. If it still doesn't work out, we are going to go to safe mode. So let's just say that it still doesn't work out, nothing worked in this video. I'm going to show some couple other things which you can try out to fix this problem over here, because I get this a couple times, and like I showed you, pulling the disk out always works on me. And for some type of reason, once the disk is on my PS5, like in my PS5, it makes a lot of sound. For some type of reason, I don't understand it, it makes a lot of sound. So now I get all of my games digital, it's a lot better for me. So if you want to get the PS5, I suggest you guys to get it digital, because it's a bit better, unless you want to play also some PS4 games. But now I'm going to go to safe mode. So I also need to do some cable management. It's a bit messed up. But what I'm going to do is, first off, disconnect it from my Elgato game capture card. If you have the Elgato game capture card or a switch like this, let me show you, because this is important. Like this, disconnect it, guys. Because if you want to go to safe mode, you have to disconnect it, and you want to make sure that the monitor and the PS5 is directly linked with them. So don't use this between them or Elgato, and make sure that you're not on rest mode. And I'm also going to show you that, how to get out of rest mode. So before I plug out my HDMI, I want to show you this. So what you want to make sure of is that you don't go to rest mode. And if you notice, guys, once I log in like this, and if I turn my PS5 off like this from here, it's going to go to rest mode. Watch this quickly. Once you see a yellow light or an orange light, it means that it's in rest mode. And I'm going to show you how you can just turn that completely off, guys. So now, keep watching, it's gonna go to yellow or orange, and you don't want that, guys. That's bad. Or you cannot even go to safe mode. So once you watch, okay, like you see, guys, it's giving a orange light. You don't want that, so let's go ahead and turn on our PS5 back on. Can we do that? Still blinking, so I have to wait a bit. Now I can turn it on. So let's switch our HDMI. I'm showing this, guys, because I have this problem a lot, and I show, like, I had this fix over here that always works for me. But if nothing works out for you guys, you can also try this. So I want to just help you guys. So what you want to do is, you want to go ahead and log in. First off, you want to log in firstly. And now you want to go to your account. And how do you want to turn off your PS5? It's really simple. You want to turn it off by going to the quick menu or the control center. And you want to go over to here. And once you turn it off from here, it's going to completely get turned off. So watch this, guys. It's not going to give you a yellow light or an orange light. It's just going to turn off completely. And that's what we want. And by the way, guys, please go like and subscribe. Thank you so much. So if you keep watching, like you see, it's turned off completely. And that's how we want it. Now, what you want to do is quite simple. You want to keep holding on the power button of the PS5. till you hear two beeps. Keep holding. And here we go, two beeps. And if you tell me why am I talking so much, it's because some people have like questions and I also need to answer this in this video. So don't mind me talking that much. So now what you want to do is connect your controller with your PS5. And I'm also going to show you some couple things what you need to know to fix your problem over here. That's just a screenshot. So what I'm going to do is get my cable. So guys, like you see, I have connected my PlayStation controller. And now it says already we did that. So what you can only use is this button over here. These two buttons. The PSN button, the X, and the circle button, guys. So let's first off press on the PSN button. And if you see, we cannot use these or that one. The joysticks are unavailable. Now what you want to do is you want to go to rebuild database. Go to rebuild database over here. And this is going to fix your problems. It's not resetting your PS5. So don't worry, guys. This is only going to get rid of your corrupted files on the system. So this could be caused by a corrupted file, stuff like that. This problem over here. So this could fix a lot of problems that are corrupted, basically, or save data, maybe. And let's just do this. What's only going to happen is it's just going to change. Let me show you guys how it looks like. It is completely safe. I'm even gonna do it myself. What's only gonna happen is your games will be changed in a different location. And I'm gonna show you how you can restore that. It's quite simple. Keep watching. So like you see, it's rebuilding database. It's only gonna take like 1 minute, not that much, basically. And I'm also gonna give you some proof, guys. So it's also switched randomly my HDMI back to my PC for some type of reason. Probably it thought it was like inactive or something like that. And by the way, guys, please like and subscribe. That will actually help me out so I can make more videos to help more people out. Thank you very much and see. Just press on the PSN button. And like you see, guys, it's completely normal. Let's go to our thing. And what you want to see is, like you see, guys, my games have completely changed some locations. So how can you restore that again? Go over to game library. And in here, you can just find all of your games again. And that's how simple it basically is. Just go to your collection. It says there is nothing here yet, but I think I'm on my wrong account, but never mind. But you just want to go over to installed, and on here you can find all of your games. And if you bought some games with your account, you can also find it on here. That's how simple it basically is. And that's how basically it is, guys, like that easy. And here you can just click on your game to restore all of your games back normal. And yeah, this was the video. I hope you enjoyed it, guys. If you did, drop a like, subscribe, and take care. I hope you fix your problem. And also, guys, last thing before I end this video, if rebuilding database didn't work out for you, use only reset PS5 as a last resort. If nothing works that I showed you with pulling the disk out and stuff like that and rebuilding database, the last resort would be reset PS5. So only use that as a last resort, like I said, guys. Remember that. Take care.